Yes, Bartek, assalamu alaikum. Mana bugun study point in JS hamda University of Technology Malaysia bilan birgalikda navbatdagi webinarimizni boshlaymiz. Webinar week hali davom etmoqda. Bugungi mehmonlarimiz Dr. Muhammad Kasim hamda Mr. Ashraf. Bular UTM, ya'ni University of Technology Malaysia taqdim qilishyapti. Bugun aynan shu universitet haqida gaplashib o'tamiz. Xo'p, bu universitet UTM juda ham bir ilg'or universitetlardan bittasi. Именно IT sohasida Malayziya yetakchi o'rinlarda bo'ladi va dunyodagi reytingi QS ranking bo'yicha 187-o'rinda. Bu degani top 500 talik qilgan universitet hisoblanadi. Xo'p, assalomu alaykum our dear partners. It's very nice to see you today in our webinar. I hope it will be really productive. So, Mr. Faris, you can start.
Yeah, okay. Thank you so much, Mr. Iskandar. Assalamualaikum and very good afternoon, everyone. Welcome again to the Study in Malaysia webinar week, Uzbekistan. So, today we are glad to have a representative from University of Technology Malaysia, UTM, one of the premier and university in Malaysia. So today we have Dr. Associate Professor Dr. Muhammad Kasim, the Director of Student Recruitment and Admission Division from UTM. Welcome, Doctor. And we do also have Mr. Ashraf from UTM Space. Okay, let me begin our session today by show you a little bit presentation about study in Malaysia and why the students, you know, should consider Malaysia as your next study destination. Okay, we do have a variety of reasons, okay, for students to consider Malaysia as their next study destination. But here I will focus on some of the important points for the students. Okay, the first one is that in terms of the affordability. For your information, Malaysia is ranked as the second most affordable city for the students. This is based on the QS ranking. So basically, study in Malaysia is very affordable in terms of both tuition fee and also living expenses. Okay, for your information here, this is the diagram. If you do the comparison between Malaysia and other study destination, of course, Malaysia have the lowest tuition fee compared to other major study destination. For example, here in a public university, this is just the estimated cost per year. It's roughly around $4,400 in a public university, whereby in a private university is around $4,970. Okay, so QS ranking, we do have about 8 Malaysian universities listed in the world top 200 ranking, including University of Technology Malaysia, UTM, that with us currently. And then besides that, if we go by the subjects also, we do have many of Malaysia university listed in the world top 50 and world top 100 by subject. For example, in terms of engineering, in terms of theology and religious study, and also in terms of the tourism and hospitality program. We do have a lot of university ranked in the top ranking of the world. So meaning that if you study in Malaysia, you can get a world-class quality education with very affordable prices. Okay, talking about prices, this is the comparison, okay, your information. How much is a McMeal on average, the comparison of McDonald's McMeal compared to other study destinations? So Malaysia listed as the lowest, the cheapest, which is 3.65 per meal compared to USA, New Zealand and other country. And then if you go about the rental, okay, about the apartment rental, in the capital city, meaning this one in Kuala Lumpur, roughly is about $1,026. Okay, This is sourced from the Global Property Price 2019. So compared to other study destination, of course, Malaysia are way cheaper in terms of you know, the living expenses and also the food, the tuition fees and everything. Okay. Another one is to learn English, because in Malaysia, we are ranked as the third most proficient country in terms of English speaker in Asia. Okay, this is so for the students, they, if you come and study in Malaysia, you don't have any issues to communicate with locals. For example, if you want to take the public transportation, if you want to buy food, if you want to go to shopping and everything, so English is not an issue. In fact, most of the universities here in Malaysia, regardless public or private, all of the program, most of the program actually was is taught in English. So communication is not an issue here in Malaysia. So besides, Malaysia also is a modern and progressive country. If you can see here, some of the good ranking that we want to highlight. For ease of doing business, we are number 15 in the world. For the global competitiveness, we are ranked at the 25th in the world. So basically, Malaysia are quite modern and also progressive country. This is the skyline of our city center in Kuala Lumpur. And Malaysia also, we do have several top multinational companies that have the office here in Malaysia. For example, Petronas, the Maybank, the financial institution, the Axiata, Sandabi, AirAsia, one of the best low-cost airline, also based in Malaysia. So basically, we do have quite a number of international students after their graduation, after they finish study here in Malaysia, so they work at these multinational companies. So if you see in the picture here, we do have a lot of skyscrapers. For example, here you can see the first picture, our famous KCC Twin Tower, the tallest twin tower in the world, and in next few years we're going to have a few others skyscrapers. Okay, and then besides, we also have a multicultural society. Okay, we do have Malay, Chinese, Indian and other races. Besides Malaysia also, we do have more than 20 years of experience in terms of student recruitment, national student recruitment. And we host the students from more than 150 countries. So the population here, in terms of the international students, in terms of our own population. So once you come and study in Malaysia, you can mix and interact with all these people from other countries. So you can learn their culture, you can learn their practices and everything. So it will expose you to the world culture. So it's good for you once you graduate. As you work, so because you already have this international exposure. Besides Malaysia, also we are blessed with the beautiful natural resources, and then it offers you a dynamic lifestyle for international students. So if you can see some from the picture here, we do have some of the world's most beautiful islands. For example, in Perhentian Island, and also Langkawi Islands, one of the most beautiful islands in Malaysia. And for most of the students, during their semester break or during their weekend, they can have a short trip to all these beautiful places. So it's good for the students. They can do the relax and everything. They can go for the hiking, they can go for the theme park, they can go for the snorkeling at this world beautiful islands. Okay. And also besides Malaysia, also we do have a very strategic location. You can see from the map here, Malaysia located at the heart of Southeast Asia countries. So if you come and study in Malaysia, you want to go to Bali, for example, it just takes about 3 hours. If you want to go to Phuket, or if you want to go to Krabi, one of the most famous islands in the world, it just take you about 1 to 2 hours only. Okay, so this is one of the some of the reasons, okay, for the students to study in Malaysia. So besides Malaysia, also is quite peaceful. We are ranked as the third most peaceful country in Asia, And alhamdulillah, the country also is free from all those big natural disasters. For example, big earthquake, volcanoes and everything. So it's quite peaceful to study here in Malaysia. Okay, so next I will show you a short video presentation about the study here, about the, a short video presentation about the students' experience in Malaysia. Okay.
So thrilled to be here in Malaysia, and I really like my university because university presents me so many opportunities to become fluent, natural, when it comes to English language as well.
I'm trying to travel in Malaysia because Malaysia is a very beautiful country with beautiful nature, and I want to see as much as possible here.
Sea or ocean before, I had so many feelings inside myself. This beauty turned my world upside down. I was about to cry. I really didn't want to believe that this happening in reality, and that's why I'm happy.
Я определенно хотел бы, чтобы каждый, кто живет в моей стране, обязательно побывал там, где сейчас я нахожусь, потому что это такое необыкновенное. Такое прекрасное место, где каждый человек может найти все, что он хочет. Особенно, если ты действительно хочешь получить прекрасное образование, это один из самых лучших вариантов.
Okay, that's all the short video about study and also about the reasons to study in Malaysia. So, without further ado, we can move to our next agenda. So I will give a floor to University Technology Malaysia, UTM, okay, to present their program and also to present their university, what they offer and everything. So yeah, I'll give the floor to UTM, Dr. Kasim, okay, or Ashraf to give the presentation. Doctor, you mute, doctor.
Thank you, Raja. Should I or should Ashraf present?
So that kalau Dr. Pilihan dia, saya add on je, kalau ada add on.
Okay, let me see. Okay, I'll take some time and to upload. I think while waiting, I was editing something just now.
Yeah, okay.
Let me open the file.
Or I can start, Doctor, if you want me to start dulu.
I can start.
Okay.
Just showing everybody some pictures about UTM. Can you see me now? My slide?
Yeah.
Okay. Good evening, everybody. It is now 7:15 in Malaysia, PM. So my name is Dr. Kasim. I am the Director of Admission and Student Recruitment of UTM. Briefly, I think I will take around 10-15 minutes of your time to show you how UTM looks like and what we offer to all the Uzbekistan students. Whatever. Suddenly disappear. Let me see what happened. Ashraf, can you proceed? I think something wrong with my slide.
Okay.
It's frozen.
Boleh. Okay, hi. Basically, on behalf of UTM, I would like to thank Mr. Iskandar and of course Raj Faris from EMJS to conduct this particular webinar. So, straight to the point, basically, UTM is one of the five research university status in Malaysia. So, in terms of research university, that means is the top five, top ranking university in Malaysia at the moment. Of course, the other four on top of us is pretty much University Malaya, University Putra, University Science, and our National University Kebangsaan, followed by ourselves. But as you know, in general, pretty much all these five universities, in particular, are pretty much major in their own field. UTM is well known with their focus in engineering programs. So if anything got to do with engineering, so UTM is actually your destination of studies. Of course, other universities have their own specialty. I won't talk much about the other universities. So in terms of pathway for Uzbekistan students, well, Central Asia is always a destination for your students to come to Malaysia. Mainly is because of the affordable fees, one, and of course the lifestyle. Pretty much most of the Central Asia country like Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, majority of them who comes here are Muslim students. So when they come here, they feel at home, meaning they can find, you know, McDonald's, halal KFC, so they like it. So meaning Central Asia students, Kazakh students, Uzbek students, pretty much they adapt very well in terms of when they like to study here in Malaysia. Of course, specifically in UTM, they would love it if they want to come to study in UTM. Of course, there's two ways of going for international students to come in, is either private or public universities. So in terms of public, if you are more interested or inclined towards engineering programs, so UTM is your destination, pretty much, if you are into that. But in terms of fees, like, for example, when Dr. Kasim shared earlier, before we start going live, he said that, you know, the fees would increase. You know, even so, you know, the following years, it will increase 5% and 5%. That's pretty much very, very normal. In fact, we are actually, UTM is actually lagging behind in terms of, you know, start to charge students for what they learn, because it costs a lot, you know, to open a university. You know, it costs a lot to pay for the professors who teaches the students, you know. So even the why we need to increase also is because the help from the government is not there anymore. We are actually instructed by the Ministry of Higher Education to start generating our own income. Bottom line, to start to fend for ourselves nowadays. The government will not support the universities anymore. They are expecting the universities to generate their own income. So these are one of the reasons why the fees are actually going to increase year by year in the future. But even said so, our fees is way, way behind the market price in terms of, you know, if you compare it to private universities, it will cost 3 times more for the same degree. You know, for example, an engineering degree, it will cost almost 200,000 in TELUS University or in Monash University here in Malaysia. But it only costs, like Dr. Kasim mentioned earlier, it's only costs about nearly 80,000. Or if you go via IDP, it's about the same price. So it's still quite, I would not say cheap. Cheap sounds bad to me. It's more affordable. It's more affordable for international students to actually come in and enjoy UTM fees. And if you do your research, our fees are extremely, extremely affordable compared to the other, even also called public universities. We are so much affordable. Mind you, because our foundation programs are focusing on the pathway is for engineering programs or more towards technology type of programs. So it's foundation in engineering at the moment, or foundation in science, some call it. But of course, in the future, we are developing in biospace. We are actually developing for social science, meaning for students who wants to go into the social science program like human resource, accounting, for example, they will follow this social science foundation. We're still in the we're still in the process of doing so. But then at the moment we are only having foundation in engineering. A 1 year program, especially for Uzbek year 11 students, I understand, because normally in Uzbek students they need to complete their pre-U university exam first or diploma in secondary education before they can come go straight to their so-called first year. That also then you need to do your bridging program. So this 1 year foundation program is totally different. It's basically specifically for students who finish their year 10. In your case, it's year 11. Or normally in IGCSE is year 10, IGCSE. So after they finish the year 10, so with minimum entry requirement, which equivalent to 5 Bs in O-levels, you can actually come in to do your 1 year foundation program before you proceed to do your bachelor program, the program of choice, pretty much. So it can be civil, it can be architecture or quantity surveying, whatever you want. Computer science. Computer science is very popular nowadays, yeah. So software engineering is one. Data engineering is one, so it's getting more popular nowadays. So you need to complete that 1 year foundation in UTM with a CGPA of 3.0 minimum before you can actually proceed to your bachelor program. So there's two ways of getting into bachelor program. Probably Dr. Kasim also can explain a bit later, or I can explain also. There's a UTM IDP. IDP stands for International Degree Program. Or if your results are good, meaning you are scoring more than 3.5, for example, you can actually use your SRAT or Dr. Kasim's office pathway to get a much lesser, or soon not going to be much lesser, it's going to be same price as IDP also, kan, Dr. Kasim, kan? So there's two ways for you to get in. So yeah, but then in foundation program, long story short, an Uzbek student needs to actually achieve a minimum of CGPA 3.0 in order for them to be eligible to continue to progress to do their bachelor program. So, because I pass the floor to Dr. Kasim. Probably Dr. Kasim wants to continue on about the bachelor programs.
Thank you, Ashraf. I think I'm back. I hope everybody can see my slide now. Let me maximize it. Okay. Again, my name is Dr. Kasim from Admission Office. Okay, this is the picture of UTM, one of in front of the library, one of the libraries that we have. We have three libraries. This is one of them. Okay, this is the gate, the main gate, the entrance. I will explain to you. We have two campuses, one in Johor Bahru, the second largest city, bordering Singapore and Indonesia. And one small campus, we call it city campus, in the capital city of Kuala Lumpur. Okay, this is in Johor Bahru, our main campus, in the evening. In the center of the campus, you'll find a Masjid Sultan Ismail. So this is the three-floor masjid. It can accommodate around, I think, a few thousand, close to 10,000 congregants. So basically, you see around the masjid, a lot of buildings, academic administration and so on. And also, as far as you can see, basically that is the UTM campus. So it is quite big, 1,200 hectares. If you like jogging, so you can jog from one gate to the other gate. We have around 4 or 5 gates. From one gate to the other is around 7 kilo. It's nice, guarded and gated and very safe for students. So you're talking about 1,200 hectare campus. Okay, again, the picture of the mosque. Okay, as you may know, in Malaysia, we have hundreds of universities. Out of these, 20 are public universities. And we are one of the 20 public universities in Malaysia. And we are top 5 Malaysian universities. Okay, and this is our ranking in the world by QS ranking. We are top 200 overall in the world, top 15 in the world for universities under 50 years old, and then top 50 in Asia as well. And student population is around 25,000, 24 plus, around 25,000. And out of that, postgraduate, master's and PhD, we have around 9,000 plus. And undergraduate, bachelor, we have around 14,000 plus. And out of the whole population of around 25,000, we have around 4,500 international students, out of which 1,800 or close to 2,000 are doing bachelor with us from more than 75 countries. So if you are connected to UTM, you are connected to the world. It's a very big campus, a lot of international students. So, okay, again, I think this is the view. When you enter our main campus in Johor Bahru, you'll see this little lake. So normally students jog around in the evening, you know, relaxing after a stressful day of studying in UTM. Okay, and this is the campus in Kuala Lumpur, not very big, it's a city campus. We are, I think, the closest public university or university to KLCC, Kuala Lumpur City Centre. I will show you some pictures later on. So basically it is around 40 hectares campus. A lot more to follow after this. Okay, why do you choose UTM? Our degree is recognized worldwide. We are the member of Washington Accord. We are the first Muslim country joining this league, elite group of Washington Accord, more than 10 years ago. And later on, Turkey joined, and now a lot more Muslim countries are the member of Washington Accord. So with our degree, you can go all over the world upon your graduation to find jobs. You see? And also we are connected to many, many partners, academic partners, universities around the world. You have the opportunity to study abroad for 6 months or 1 year, depends on your qualification and also your funding. And also we have a lot of industrial partners for our students to do practical training. So every UTM student is required to do 10 weeks practical training on year 3 before they graduate. Okay, these are basically the field that we offer. Engineering, all sorts of engineering, from chemical engineering until nuclear engineering. So you have marine, offshore, in between, mechanical, electrical, mechatronic, and many field of engineering. So UTM is the biggest engineering university in Malaysia. And sciences, physics, chemistry, biology, biosciences, forensic science, and so on. And IT, computer, big data, networking, security, software engineering, multimedia, everything is offered to international students. And then business and management, land administration, property management, accounting, project management at master's level, human resource and development, and psychology, HRD, and many options. Yeah. And then built environment and architecture, construction science, landscape architecture, industrial design, geography, and related area. Also education. We do not offer at undergraduate level, but we do offer at master's and PhD level. Again, it's a big area. It depends on your interest. Okay, I'll show you a little bit or a little more pictures about our campus life. You see, recreational activities is abundance in UTM. You can do jogging, hiking, in campus forest, boat riding, and then horse riding, cycling, and co-curricular activities. Yeah. Also, we have excellent facilities on campus. We have a health center, including dental clinic, bowling alley in Kuala Lumpur, bank, post office, and you name it. It is like a mini town, basically. Everything is self-contained within the campus. And again, recreational activities. We have stadium on campus, camping ground, gymnasium, and sport facilities, and so on. These are basically our libraries. We have two big libraries, 4 floors each in Johor Bahru campus, and one big one in Kuala Lumpur. And this is the stadium in Johor Bahru for UTM students. It is not open for public. So basically, it's a real big stadium for you to play, to jog, to join athletic clubs and so on. Yeah, swimming pool, Olympic size. 24-hour health service, health center with 3 ambulance on standby and 15 doctors, including 3 dentists, fully employed by UTM. So you don't have to worry if you, in case of emergency, our service is there to help you. Okay, this again, health center, free, outpatient treatment is free. Inpatient, you are covered under insurance when you come to Malaysia. UTM health center again, is emergency room. A dental office, dental clinic, sorry. And then hostel varies according to your finance, your level of affordability. It varies from $150 up to $250 a month. It depends on your choice. Okay, campus residence, so we have basic one, medium, and also the upscale, the hotel, our campus hotel as well. Okay, this is our campus hotel, Scholars Inn we call it. We have one big one, 2 towers in Johor Bahru and one in Kuala Lumpur, a small one. And we in Kuala Lumpur, we have 2 hotels, Widat and Residency. So it's also open for you to for long-term rental. Okay, horse riding. This is UTM Kuala Lumpur. You see the KLCC in the background. These are basically our residential area. This is our lecture room, lecture hall, sorry. Okay, this is Malaysia Japanese Institute of Technology within UTM. This is in Kuala Lumpur. If you like bigger city, you can study in Kuala Lumpur. If you have, you don't mind a smaller city, you can study in Johor Bahru. Johor Bahru is 1.5 million, Kuala Lumpur is around 3.5 million population. Okay, again, this is Razak Tower in Kuala Lumpur. A real picture, I took this picture, the bottom left. So on the rooftop, you can take picture, with the Kuala Lumpur City Center in the background. Okay, again, this is UTM Kuala Lumpur. This is the campus mall. I think among few universities in Malaysia with mall facilities. So this is, we call it UTM Kuala Lumpur Residency Mall. So you can find anything, all the entertainment, bowling, cinema is not there yet, but fast food restaurant like Burger King, McDonald's, KFC, Pizza Hut, many, many other cafe for you to enjoy. Yeah. So basically the tower, the 1, 2, 3, these are residential area. This is the hotel in the middle. And then the lecture room is just behind this building. Yeah, so it's very convenient. This is the bigger picture of the aerial view. So we have a mosque next to it, hotel, and 2 hotels, 1 residential area, tower, sorry. Okay, again, picture of Kuala Lumpur. And we have free bus service for students to move around campus, both in Johor Bahru and Kuala Lumpur. And again, more than 4,500 students from more than 75 countries. We have some small number of Uzbekistan and Tajikistan and Kazakhstan students, not that many. But you will find a lot more students from other countries. Okay, if you need more information about admission, you can visit admission.utm.my. Everything is there, including the fees entry requirement. Like Mr. Ashraf told you just now, all the Uzbekistan student going through the national curriculum of Uzbekistan need to go through 1 year foundation in UTM. Upon the completion of foundation, you can apply to join our degree program. So the entry requirement varies. For social sciences, it is a little bit lower. For architecture, 3.0 CGPA from foundation. For engineering, 2.8 and above. For education, 2.5. And a selected engineering program, like in Kuala Lumpur, is 2.5 as well. So it varies. Some have higher requirement, some have lower requirement. It depends on your choices as well. Okay, with that, I hope I will see some of you in UTM. And if you need further information, don't hesitate to contact us while we are here. So back to you, Iskandar.
Yes, thank you very much for clear information. It was really fruitful for our future students. And regarding, I have some questions. Do you have any scholarships for Uzbekistan students or not?
We have. If you have straight A student, we can give 3 scholarship. You pay local fee, which is equivalent to how much is it? $3,000, less than. Around 3? Yeah, $3,000 for 4 years. So but you need to complete the condition first. Yeah?
What is the requirements for that scholarship?
We need, the entry requirement to our degree program upon completion of the foundation, we require the 3 major subjects. If you are joining engineering programs, you must have, for general entry requirement, you must have B equivalent or good standing, B equivalent in math, in physics, and in chemistry or biology, B in general, yeah? If you you're planning to join computer science, you must have mathematics and 2 other subjects, either in science or IT. If you need scholarship, the 3 subjects should be A. Then we can consider giving you scholarship, which is almost 90% reduction of the fees. That is very, very attractive. The total value, the total amount that you need to pay a year is around $1,000 approximately for 4 years. $3,000 plus for 4 years. But you need to complete 1 year foundation under Mr. Ashraf, under UTM Space.
All right. So UTM Space located in Kiel, right?
UTM Space both in Johor Bahru and Kuala Lumpur. If you plan to join mechanical, electrical, and chemical engineering in Kuala Lumpur, you can do foundation in Kuala Lumpur. Also, software engineering is available in Kuala Lumpur and industrial design. 5 programs are currently being offered in UTM Kuala Lumpur. And the rest, everything is offered in Johor Bahru. I think beginning next year, there will be more programs offered in Kuala Lumpur. In addition to that, they have general studies, business, bachelor of general studies, I think BGS.
BGS and BBA.
Yeah, BBA.
Business program. So currently all in KL campus, mostly IT and engineering related program, right?
Not really. IT, only 1 at the moment. I think next year we will be offering another 2 more. IT, engineering, and... we will increase the number of programs in Kuala Lumpur.
That's good, because the foundation also the students can do from KL.
Yeah, they have the option to study in KL or in Johor Bahru.
All right. So, what is your strengths? Which programs you can like advise to?
I would claim we are the best in engineering. 60% of our campus population, including the professors, are in engineering. And architecture program is the best in Malaysia. We set up a lot of architecture program for Taylor's University, UTM set it up. University Malaya, UTM set it up. IIUM, we set up the program. We loan our people, we loan our knowledge to them. So basically, we set up many, many architecture school in Malaysia. And then IT also, we are one of the biggest, I would say the biggest IT university in Malaysia. Almost 3,000 students at, so it's a big department of IT.
So this really sounds good. So after graduating engineering in UTM, where they can work in Malaysia or other countries?
Any place they accept them. Our degree is recognized.
I mean, the most of your... where they will continue their career?
You see, out of 1,800, most of the students, international students doing degree in UTM, they are basically the children of the upper middle class. Upon graduation, they just return home, continue the job with their parents, whatever. So that is the situation. And then postgraduate, master's and PhD, mostly sponsored student. They are scholar, high ranking officers. For example, Afghanistan, we have around 100 plus Afghani, mostly lecturers. Pakistan, mostly lecturers of the top universities in Pakistan. And Nigerian, almost all of them are basically civil servants, high-ranking civil servants. So they didn't have any problem getting jobs. So they just go back to their place. But in all this, around 10 years ago, we used to have big number of Iranian students, you know, private students. So they came to Malaysia in UTM, almost 2,000 of them doing masters and PhD. And the rest, some portion left for Iran. The rest migrated to Canada and Australia. So now there are many, many of them have PhD and working over there with our degree. So no That's problem. Good. You can so go
have
anywhere.
From Uzbekistan?
Uzbekistan, we used to have a small number. We Kazakhstan, a lot more. All Bolashak, the presidential scholar, they used to send around 30 a year.
How about Uzbekistan? How many students you have, like around 5, 7?
I think I would say less than 10 Uzbekistan students. Okay. Many. Yeah. It's a new market to for us. I think this is the first event that we conduct with you. We have not penetrated the Uzbekistan market yet. This is the first time for me for the mainstream programs. Yeah.
Inshallah, we will try to promote.
Yeah.
So from my side, everything was clear. I received full information about UTM, about the student life, about everything. And Mr. Faris, do you have some questions?
Yeah, just some question regarding the English requirement. Because I know UTM, you know, have some kind of a special pathway with collaboration from ELS.
ELS and Language Academy. We have two options.
Okay, okay. Can you elaborate on that?
So, all international students are required to pass the CIFA B2 requirement. Or CIFA B2 is a new framework. for undergraduate, IELTS 5.5 minimum. For postgraduate, master and PhD 6.0. So if you do not fulfill the English requirement, you have the two options, either to do with our partner, ELS. ELS and UTM, ELS is operating inside UTM now. Beginning August, they will operate inside UTM Johor Bahru. And then, or you have the option to study under our Language Academy. At the end of the program, in Language Academy, you must take IELTS. And you must pass the mark that I just told you. And for ELS, you must pass 107, level 107 for undergraduate and 108 for postgraduate. So it's very convenient. You don't need a separate visa. It's part of your study. You can study either in ELS or in our Language Academy.
Yeah. So meaning those who take the program with ELS doesn't need to go for the IELTS?
No need. It's a CIFA compliant.
Okay. Okay, that's good. Another question regarding the transfer student. Let's say, right, if the students currently doing a second year degree in Uzbekistan, they want to transfer to UTM, for example. So is there any credit exemption?
Yeah, definitely. If you have B and above, normally faculty will allow you to transfer. If you have covered at least 70% or 80% of the subject, the similarity, 70 to 80% similarity of the similar subject in UTM, you'll get credit exemption.
Okay.
Yeah.
You have these questions, you know, from some of the students before. This is one of the acquired by the student, those who study.
Yeah, we accept many, many transfer students from Egypt, from Bangladesh, from all over the world. So no issue.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so
provided your high school results are good.
Okay. So I think all clear, everything covered already. So I understand tadi kalau the difference between UTM and UTM space in terms of entry requirement, right? So to go to after the foundation, if to go for the UTM, the mainstream, so students need to get 3.5 and above.
No, not really. Depends on the program. Depends on the program. Ashraf was giving the general requirement, but it again depends on the individual program. Some programs, social science and humanities, has lower. lower requirement engineering 2.8, but for architecture 3.0. So because architecture has limited seat, very limited. They take only around 10, 20 international students per year. So then, you know, those who apply, around 50, 60 of them, you can imagine. So they have to select the best.
Why I mentioned 3.0 and above is just for them to be safe, though, Raja Faris.
Yeah, safe.
Because so once they do foundation, in the back of their mind is they want to progress to do a bachelor degree in Malaysia also, right? So just to make sure that
on the safe side,
they're not stuck anywhere. So just to be safe, because if you ask them, tell them it's 2.5, they will target 2.5, they end up going to get 2.2.
They have to go to other places.
Exactly. So we must always put high.
Yes, high requirement.
As long as you got 3.0 and above, there's high chances for you to
go. You're safe.
To...
You're safe. Yeah.
Okay. Because UPM pun the campus, I saw they have a very nice, good apartment, right? They are for traditional students.
Yeah, residential. And in Kuala Lumpur, we call it residency, or Widat Hotel, or Scholars Inn. We have three over there. Three hotels in KL.
That's my office.
Yeah. Widat,
I'm right? I'm based in UTM
residency.
KL.
Yeah.
Residency,
very second beautiful office of UTM Space in Kuala Lumpur. Hmm. And in Johor Bahru, we have KLG. KLG Residence. It is an international village. That can accommodate around 1,200 students. And you have the option also to live outside. Condo. A lot of condos, you can share, triple share, twin sharing. Cheap in Malaysia. The rental is cheap. RM1,500, you can get decent condo in KL, RM1,500 to 2,000. You can share 2-3 of you. And furnished though. Yeah.
Do you provide the transportation shuttle from hostel to the
hostel within campus? We do. Yeah, within campus we do. But you can always travel using Uber equivalent. We call it Grab in Malaysia. It's very cheap. $1.50. You get, to travel for 5 kilo. Very cheap. Yeah. Except the peak hour is slightly more expensive.
Yeah. I know that.
Yeah, very convenient. You can order food using Grab Food or Food Panda.
Panda.
If you are lazy, you don't want to go out, you want to eat some, pilaf, then just order online. They deliver on the door. Yeah. Uzbekistan pilaf or whatever,
yeah.
That's great. Yeah, perhaps Nation.
Yeah.
By the way, did you try the real pilaf or not?
Not yet. I tried the Pakistani pilaf. I've never been to. The closest Turkish country that I've been to was Azerbaijan.
Oh.
I transited in Uzbekistan on the way to Azerbaijan.
Come to Uzbekistan and you will try the real plot because others.
Yeah, I know. I saw the big pot. Yeah.
The real one is here in Uzbekistan.
Yes.
Actually, it's my first plot in Uzbek embassy in Kuala Lumpur. your embassy people cook.
But the taste is not the same, you know.
Not the same.
No.
That was good enough for me already, man. That's the best.
Got the big frying pan, like a 3 meter.
You will forget about that plov, you know. Trust me, they are nothing.
Yeah. I saw in the National Geography. That's it. Really good.
Sedap. The best. The best rice dish ever is plov.
Yeah.
More than mandi, more than kapsha.
I know.
It's unbelievable. Yeah.
they cook very, very good food.
Oh,
yeah.
And even Malaysia, like, really good food, you know, because I'm a big fan
Malaysia,
of
Malaysia, but very healthy.
I'm a big fan of Maggi Goreng.
Yeah, nasi goreng is bad.
No, not nasi goreng, Maggi Goreng.
Maggi Goreng. Yeah. So, nice food in KL.
My son.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah. Iskandar, do you have any further question from the viewers?
Everything simply awesome. I really like today's conversation. It was really good.
Yeah. Okay. We do have 10 more minutes. Thank you so much, Dr. Kasim and also Mr. Ashraf for a good sharing okay, about UTM to our viewers in Uzbekistan. So for all the viewers, you know, who want to, say if you want to study Malaysia or if you want to study UTM specifically, do not hesitate contact us, or you can, you know, drop by your message to Study Point directly, and then we will do the best to assist you for the preparation to study in Malaysia. Okay, so Mr. Iskandar, any words from you?
Yeah, thank you very much, Mr. Kasim, Dr. Kasim. It was really good for today.
Yeah,
we'll recruit a lot of students to UTM, inshallah, for the future. From my side, I want to say that everything was perfect. I really liked your university, and I want to visit when I will be in Malaysia, inshallah.
You are welcome anytime, Iskandar. Just let me know. There is my number. I just give you through the chat window.
Okay.
So contact me anytime. Okay. You need any information. There is my WhatsApp number as well.
Yeah,
sure. So I can arrange for you.
Okay. So
Raja, you are welcome to visit me in Johor.
Yeah,
you
sure.
Are stuck in KL all the time.
Saya dekat ni pun dia tak pernah visit pun, tak.
Oh my god. It's just Pelawang, it's very close. You cycle to UTM KL, very very close.
Control
way.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, just to add on, Iskandar, just a bit tips for especially the Central Asia students. Just make sure that their English, they are well prepared before, because most often the main issue for Central Asian students are basically their English, because if they can do their English before they come, it will be much better. But of course, if they don't have the English qualification, they can always do with us in UTM via our language academy or via ELS, up to their choice. So soon we're gonna offer also, doctor, if you don't know, soon we're gonna offer MUET also for
MUET is CIPA compliant.
CIPA compliant
is MUET on the go, they call it.
Yep. So yeah, that's another option for international students. Yeah. They can do MUET also. One it will be based in Kuala Lumpur, in our campus in Kuala Lumpur. So soon. In fact, it's starting very, very soon, and this week, if I'm mistaken. But yes, there's many choices for international students to do English before they join. But must always stress on the students is their level of English, because everything from foundation onwards is going to be 100% in English. So sometimes they're a bit culture shock because of the English being used. Yeah. So hopefully they are prepared with their English before they come. Academy, I'm not so worried, but many of them, not just Central Asia, in fact, from Arab also, is the English, is their main answer. From China, for example, they just give up because they cannot comprehend the level of English in terms of in higher education. Because last time it's just in high school, if they don't know, you know, at the end of the class, the teacher's going to help them out. But with the moment they enter university, they will not get that anymore, no more spoon feed, they need to find their own answers. And some students, especially international, they will get frustrated and demotivated, and they want to go home just because of English, just because of language. So just stress on how important it is for them to at least have a basic English before they come.
Yeah,
because it's going to be 100% in English for them. Just be sure, be positive to them. Just after the 4 years, you're going to speak much better English before you come to Malaysia. That one I can confirm you. You can be better English after 4 years, that's for sure.
Actually, to be honest, I share with my own experience, because even me, I studied in Malaysia. I graduated Segi Damansara, so I lived there 4 years, and I'm sharing with my own experience about the language in Malaysia and like pronunciations, slangs, you know.
That's so it, there's much. So,
you can just tell from your experience, yes. Your experience to your student.
Yeah, that's our selling point of Malaysia.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Of course, to add on to Dr. Kasim, we are always here to help you guys. Dr. Kasim already forward his mobile number. You can get my mobile number, mobile number as well. So if you have any questions or any inquiries, you can
WhatsApp us anytime.
Yeah, so okay. We will answer all your inquiries, no worries.
Okay, no problem.
Send the blue-eyed students, eh?
Contact lenses will do.
All right. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much for today.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Thank you, Mr. Ashraf.
Thank you. Good evening.
See you.
Okay. 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 Okay.